Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 10.1, Problem 5. This is Section 10.1, Problem number 5. It says, Gary Gambler claims that his average monthly gambling losses are at most $300. Help Gary set up a hypothesis test. So first, what is the null hypothesis? So now usually what we have is mu, the population average, equals some number, and the number that we're working with here is 300. Now Gary doesn't say that it equals 300 or it's gone up or down. He's saying it's at most 300. So at most, that's the most it could be. So he claims that his gambling loss is less than or equal to 300. 300 is the most. The real number is 300 or less. That's what he means by at most 300. 300 is the most. So now, if that's the null hypothesis, the symbol would be capital H with a subscript of 0, and we put our colon. The alternate hypothesis would be the opposite. H, capital H with a subscript of 1 for alternate hypothesis. The colon, the same mu, the symbol for population average, the same number, 300 in this case, but it would be the opposite. So it would be that the real average is greater than 300. So Gary claims that it's 300 or less, and the alternate would be the opposite, that it's greater than 300. Again, the null hypothesis, the H sub 0, always contains the condition of equality, whether it's just regular equals or an inequality with an or equal to. Now, for C, what is this a left, right, or two-tail test? So to determine if it's left, right, or two-tail, you want to look at the inequality symbol in the alternate hypothesis and see which way it points. The alternate hypothesis has a greater than symbol, which points to the right. So this is a right-tail hypothesis test.